Welcome back from that very short break. We are glad you're still a part of us here on Innovate. Now, with the increasing technology advancements, there has also been changes when it comes to education system. And now Abraham has proved so with the School Made Easy, a tutorial that is put on DVDs with animations for students in secondary school. Take a look.
Abraham Mutukiriza invested in a project called School Made Easy SME to improve the learning of school subjects and is enjoying seeing its impact on the academics of users.
Abraham Mutukiriza, I'm 27 years old and I graduated from Makerere University Business School with a bachelor's in Human Resource Management, but I also studied audio engineering at SM School of Music. So right now I do more of audio engineering and video editing than human resource management. And I am married with a son who is 1 year old. Yeah, that's basically who I am.
SME is a tool which has tutorials with animations placed on DVDs for students to learn at home or using school projectors.
So School Made Easy, I abbreviate it as SME, it's basically a startup that I came up with 1 year and a half ago. It is what I would call digital interactive video education, and that simply means video tutorials that are put on either a DVD or are uploaded on the internet for your personal use. So basically what happens is School Made Easy, we record tutorials, teachers teaching class lessons basic on the syllabus, and we record them onto the DVD. And before we do that, we edit them and we add all these illustrations, images and video clips and all that stuff that help a student relate the real world that they live in with the education that they get in class. And yeah, making education more fun and more realistic. It's basically a revision tool, just much better than textbooks and pamphlets.
Abraham started the project in 2016 with the idea of creating something different from the traditional chalk on blackboard teaching, make it interesting as well as adding value.
First of all, I passed through the same education system that most Ugandan kids are in right now. And one of the main challenges I faced, especially with science subjects, was I could not relate most of the concepts we were getting in class with my real world. Teacher talk about atoms and molecules and all that, and I'm imagining crazy things I watch in movies. So when it gets to the exam, I remember less of what I studied. So we were like, okay, how can we make this more fun, more realistic, and easily understandable by everyone who is in the education system right now? So we came up with School Made Easy. And the other thing is, personally, when I was studying audio engineering, we used mostly video tutorials. We had these tutors showing us how to use these different tools, and it proved to be more effective than just a teacher standing on a whiteboard or a blackboard and just writing figures and drawing diagrams. So yeah, that is basically what drove SME into existence.
Abraham is a graduate of Human Resource Management, has a soft spot for music, and he started a recording studio but found that challenging. Behold the birth of SME.
First and foremost, I had to brief my wife about it, and she was excited. Then the other task that came with it was to select the tutors. We had to use all the connections we had to find people who are qualified. Besides that, who can actually do teaching on camera, because it's the two different things, class and camera. So we had to do these interviews and selections. And when we got them, then we had to sit down and design a syllabus. Actually, just compare what they had with the NCDC syllabus and just follow that and come up with something that is really enriching for the students. And then after that, we had to come up with a camera crew and the editing panel, and yeah, we got things in motion.
Many people have no idea that such materials exist, and some schools do not even want their students using it because they believe it replaces their work during holidays. This has been one of the major challenges that Abraham is working to solve.
Education has lost, okay, not lost, but I'm trying to add value to the education system, because kids these days, from our time up to now, it's basically a study to pass, or cram to pass, cram to reproduce in exams. And that is not what education is supposed to do. You're supposed to study to be knowledgeable and apply that education in your daily life to solve daily life situations, problems. But kids come out of school and they can't even create jobs for themselves. They only study to pass.
Just like the name, this innovation makes all classwork easy, just like Abraham explains.
So SME is comprised of mainly the tutor. He has to be there because he delivers the information. And then it follows a syllabus. And the syllabus had to be the NCDC syllabus, National Curriculum Development Center syllabus, because that encompasses all other syllabi that are taught in other schools. So in addition to the explanation that the tutor gives on camera or on DVD, a student must see exactly what's happening in the real world. So we get these clips from the outside. If for example, it's the smallest organism like the amoeba, we demonstrate what that looks like. So that when you get to the exam, you're actually answering what you know, not what you crammed. So that is also part of SME. And then we have answers to questions that are asked in most exams, or the general structure of questions. And the other thing is we have the diagrams and all these labelings and all that stuff. Generally, it's just class med easy.
But how does he deal with the changing syllabi?
That is easy because we're dealing with digital material. We can just switch up the stuff and just compile it the way it has been laid out to us from the NCDC. However, I think to some extent it's an advantage, well, it's a disadvantage, that the syllabus we have right now has been there for quite a long time. And it's until now that the Ministry of Education actually wants to introduce ICT in schools and make learning more, you know, effective. So what I'm saying is, I think SME has stepped in the future of the Ministry of Education, because what they want to do in class is what we have packaged on DVD and are giving out to students.
With social media as their main tool, Abraham and his team are marketing SME.
We have a very active social media platform, and we have put clips and told the public what SME really does and how effective it is and how important it is for a child to have. Also, we have a website. We have also put up radio mentions here and there so that people can get to know. Because the challenge about marketing school made easy is people don't even know that you can have class on DVD. Some don't even know that can happen, that you can have a class at home and you can pause and rewind and forward, select a particular section and go over it over and over and over again. So those are the platforms we're using currently.
The tutorials are not time constrained the way classroom lessons are, so it remains in the control of the users to regulate their use.
The mode of operation makes Kumed is unique. One, it's for some of us who had low self-esteem in class and used to sit at the back, it was hard to ask the teacher, excuse me, I haven't understood that particular part of the concept. And you let it pass. You're like, you know what, I'll read from home. But now, Schoolmate Easy gives you this opportunity to select just a particular portion of the syllabus. And you're like, you know what, I want to go over more concepts 9 times. So you watch it and rewatch it until you're okay with the whole concept. That is what makes Schoolmate unique.
The target customers are secondary school students from schools that have projectors or students that have DVD players at home at the moment.
Currently, we started with the O-level section because we felt we could have a deeper impact on them. Things get harder usually starting from senior 1 to senior 4, and that's when people usually go off course and they're like, you know what, I'm losing the dreams of being a pilot and a doctor and a physician, and I'm going for either art and music or whatever. So we thought we should first solve that problem and then try to encompass everyone else from primary to HSC.
Schoolmate Easy features 3 subjects: chemistry, biology and physics. The team has also included DVDs with science practical activities that students can easily relate to.
With SME, well, currently we have 3 subjects: biology, chemistry and physics. However, we are releasing math as soon as next year. And we began with sciences because they're the most problematic subjects. The others, you know, you can always work your way around them. So in the future, we plan to have the entire layout of subjects.
SME is a new project that has garnered positive feedback from the users in different secondary schools.
Supplied SME to most of the top schools in Kampala, So in terms of numbers, I'll give us between 300 to 500 users right now. And the results are overwhelming.
One DVD is 5 to 8 hours long and contains the whole syllabus of one subject. Each costs 5,000, but soon the price will be adjusted to 2,000 shillings.
Currently, is way too low in that everyone can access it. And that was decided basing on the fact that we want to level the playing field for kids who can't afford to go to high quality schools. So we made it as low as 5,000 shillings, full syllabus for a particular class. Like S1, physics, the whole syllabus for that year is just 5,000 shillings.
The tutorials are all in English. This is an idea they're thinking about too, as they hope that SME will achieve its goals of making learning easier for both students and teachers.
School Made Easy has quite a lot. We're going to include all other subjects, like I've mentioned. But also we want to improve the mode of delivery, especially when it comes to the teachers, because we've been getting all these requests from teachers telling us, hey, how about you make for us materials we can use in class? If we have projectors and laptops and all that, how about if you also make us tools that we can use? So which means we have to eliminate the tutor and just give them a tutor to use in class. So that is also something that we are considering in the near future.
That was it for this week's show of Innovate, but be sure to catch us again next week as we bring you nothing but the best from the world of technology, both here in Uganda as well as globally, as we bring you the best from the field of technology with yours truly, Brenda Kembabazi. Have yourselves a good evening.